It's no secret that one of my favourite apps on my device is Freeform. I use it all the time for so many different things. In fact, when I was planning this series of iOS 18 videos watching the original keynote from WWDC, I had a Freeform board of all the different app icons and I was adding post-it notes as new features were coming up to give me ideas of videos to make. In fact, this is the board you're looking at now. It's quite a mess, really. Because it's so big and it sprawls over so much space, it's really hard to zoom into certain areas and jump between them quickly. Imagine I wanted to look at the photos post-it notes and the settings post-it notes and then jump backwards and forwards between the two. To do that, I'd have to zoom out and then relocate it and zoom in again. It's a pain. With iOS 18, the new Freeform Scenes feature will help me out with this. If I zoom into a certain part of my board, maybe these quick tip ideas here, and then press the More Options button in the top right-hand corner, I can add a scene. You'll see that that scene has been captured, a little bit like a screenshot. But this isn't actually a screenshot. Instead, what Freeform has done is it's looked at what's currently on your screen and it's remembered it. That means if I go to another part of my board, perhaps over on the top here, and then press the More button and add another scene, it will have two different markers on the board, which I can jump back to at any time. Let me just add one third one down here on the Photos section, and then at the bottom I'm going to press on this new Scenes menu. From here you can see the scenes that I've saved, and you can actually rename them should you want to as well. Let me just rename that last one quickly to Photos. It's good to do this if you've got lots of scenes to keep an eye on what's what. And of course, I can then tap onto any of those scene names to jump to that exact part of my Freeform board. I can even, on the Minimize menu, use the left of my arrow buttons to jump between the different scenes in order, and that means that I can really quickly switch between different sides of my board and not lose track of where I am. There's one other really cool feature about these scenes, and if you press on the Scenes menu button at the bottom again one more time, you'll then see there's a little three dots button in the bottom right-hand corner. Tapping on here will let you export all the scenes that you've selected as PDF documents. So you've not got one massive PDF document for the whole board anymore. Instead, you'll have a multi-page document, and every page is just the scene that you've selected. I think that's really handy, and it's a really nice feature to add to Freeform. And this is far from the only thing that's changed in Freeform this year. There are a couple of other really nice additions that make Freeform that little bit quicker and easier to use. You can learn more about them and everything else that's new in iOS 18 by checking out my ebook below, 100 Quick Tips for iOS 18, where I'll guide you through everything that's changed in a really friendly way. Or if you'd like some more videos, please do check out my channel as well, where there are hundreds more quick tips to help you make the most of your iPhone. Enjoy, and I'll see you later.